It's the Morning Praise Show with Coach. With us is John Schlitt, the former singer of Petra. Thanks for taking some time to talk with us this morning, John.
Hey, Coach. Good to work with you, buddy.
I know there's a lot of excitement about the Petra convention coming up May 5th here in Indianapolis. How do you feel the band is going to perform after 40 years?
A band being around for 40 years, a rock band being around for 40 years is almost a miraculous thing. But let's face it, Petra is a Christian rock band with a message that's timeless, with a vision that I think was timeless. So if any rock band was going to be around for 40 years, I think it makes sense for Petra to be that band. So I'm just excited about being part of it.
So you joined Petra back in 1986, is that right, John?
I sure did.
Were you a Petra fan before you joined the band?
I was a major fan. I knew all about the band. Someone had given me a Petra album saying, John, you won't believe this. This band sounds just like your old band, but it's Christian. I listened to it and I said, oh my gosh, why didn't I use rock and roll for this kind of thing before? And at the time, I thought I'd blown. I thought that God, there's no way God could use me doing something like this. I actually had regret in my heart because I felt that I'd blown it, and I saw the vision. I saw how rock and roll could be used in a very positive way, but thought that God could never use me. Later on, he showed me that, hey, what sin was it that was greater than the blood of Christ? And I realized, hey, maybe I could be used. About that time, Bob called me, and you know the story from then.
Now it's 2012, and Petra is 40 years old. You're still going strong. Do you guys still perform as Petra?
Yeah, actually we do. You know, I thought Petra was supposed to retire back in the New Year's of 2006, but apparently that just doesn't happen. Actually, I think there's two Petras out there now. We have a classic Petra that I'm not part of, and then we have a farewell Petra, which I am. And every once in a while, the guys and I will go out and do like a revival or something special. And it's just so much fun to be with them again and be part of that ministry that never changes. It's always to encourage the Christian and to give a new message to secular people that maybe never heard the message before. So it's always fun. It's always an exciting time.
Thanks a lot for joining us, John. We'll have more with John Schlitt right after this. You're listening to the Morning Praise Show with the Coach. Back with us in the Morning Praise Show is John Schlitt, former singer of Petra. John, the convention is May 5th. What is the convention all about?
Well, first of all, I think the convention is going to be pretty exciting. Sponsors have a lot going on. The people there, I think, are coming with high expectations, and they should. I think it's going to be a great time. I am going to do a concert by myself. I'm going to feature a lot of my solo stuff, including my newest album, The Greater Cause. But I will do some Petra stuff, too, because let's face it, that's 20 years of my life and a very important 20 years of my life. And it would be ridiculous not to share some of that with the folks, too.
I see there's going to be a question-answer session with all of you. Are you ready to hear some crazy questions that the pet heads might have to ask you?
I'm never ready what the pet heads are going to ask me. They are always coming up with things that throw me off. You can't study for it. You can't prepare. You just go in and go, well, I hope I don't make a mess of things. They're fun. They're fun because they know a lot, probably more than I do about my own history. So it's going to be an exciting time. It'll be, hopefully it'll be informational. I know it'll probably be for me. I hope it is for them.
John, you have recorded 16 records with Petra. Now you have released your fourth solo effort. What can you tell us about the new solo effort?
I just felt it was time. A lot's going on in the world today. I had a lot of people say, John, I really believe you need to do a Christian rock album again. We really miss that. And putting those two together, I agree. It was really time for me to do a rock album. And the subject matter that I wanted to cover with the a little bit of politics, a little bit of where the world's going right now. What as Christians are we doing to make a difference, to be relevant in the world today? All those subjects were important to me, and the greater cause was culmination of all of it. And I'm just excited that it's here now. And I think the completion was it was total. It was what I wanted.
How does the greater cause differ than the other CDs that you've released, John?
The Grafting was a little more introspective, I think. At that time, I had just retired from Petra. I was really searching about where I fit in the scheme of things that, you know, now. And I introspect. That's all I can say. The Grafting is a little more introspective, and the Greater Cause is more outward. It's reaching again. And both of them are very relevant for me. They're both very important records or CDs for me, and that will be part of my repertoire for many years to come. What's important to me now is really how we as Christians are how relevant are we? What are we doing in our surroundings? How are we making a difference in the world today? Are we hiding in our church and say that's good enough? Are we out there trying to make a difference in the world we're responsible for? Some will say, well, we're in this world, not of it. Yeah, we are in this world. And I believe that it's time for us to be responsible. And I think that covered a lot of that. The lyrical directions covered that. The musical, absolutely rock and roll. There is some mellower stuff, but I think it probably, there's a couple of very mellow. And I wanted that. One is a song to my wife, Dorla. Another was something that we worked with. It's a theme song for a project that we worked with ACLJ, which I'm very proud of. And so it has a lot of texture. I think it covers a lot of different music styles, but it all leans more towards rock.
John, I've heard some of the songs out of Greater Cause. Tell us, your fans helped fund that, didn't they?
It was truly amazing. It probably makes this truly the most special CD that I've ever done. There's a program called Kickstarter on the internet. And what it did was it allowed fans or people who believed in what I did or do to join with me and help me finance this CD, which I could not afford on my own. And it was truly amazing. Through the process, I ended up having over 500 partners that we together were able to put together a CD that is a category for sure. And the only way I could do that is through my Kickstarter partners. It was truly amazing.
So if people want to purchase the Greater Cause early, can they do that at the convention?
Yes. Actually, unofficially, this will be the first place where we can buy the CD. Praise God. I'm going to bring a lot of them. Couldn't think of a better place to start selling. Praise God. And after you hear it, I think folks will want a copy. It's right down the Pedheads alley, I think. And I think we're going to have a wonderful time. I'm excited. I think this PC3 is going to be an amazing time. And I'm just excited for the folks that are going to be there. And I'm looking forward to meeting them all.
John, thanks a lot for taking time out of your busy schedule. We'll see you on May 5th. The convention is at the Wingate Hotel on the west side of Indianapolis. Tickets are just $20 in advance, $30 at the door. If you have any questions about that, give us a call here at The Walk, 317-826-9255. Thanks, John.
Thank you, Coach, for being part of this and letting me share what's on my heart. God bless.